Here's some local corporate headlines. San Miguel affiliate, the new NAIA Infra Corporation, applies for a permit with the Pasay City Government for the demolition of the Philippine Village Hotel. NNIC plans to use the site to extend the current Terminal 2. The extension will cater to domestic flights and is expected to accommodate an additional 22 million passengers every year. In earnings, Vista Land and Lifescapes nets 9.1 billion pesos in the first 9 months of the year after launching 33 billion pesos worth of projects. The Villar Group says it benefited from its diversified presence in over 140 cities and towns nationwide, especially when demand in Metro Manila softened due to the POGO ban. And finally, Frutas Holdings net income jumps 35% thanks to a record-breaking 2.1 billion pesos in sales. The food and beverage brand says its gross margins expanded by 1.5 percentage points. As of end September, the company reports having 851 stores nationwide.
Asian markets kicked off the week on a mixed note. The Nikkei 225 slumped 1% after a closely watched commentary from Bank of Japan Governor Kazuo Ueda still left investors guessing on the time or the timing of interest rate hikes. The Korean Kospi, meanwhile, jumped more than 2%, boosted by index heavyweight Samsung. Shares of that tech giant surged 6% as investors got their first chance to react to its $7.2 billion share buyback, which it announced in after-hours trade Friday. Here at home, the local bourse extended its winning streak to a second straight session after snapping a seven-day losing streak last Friday.
While the PSEI has rallied in the last 2 days, we are still in the midst of a corrective phase, having seen the index fall down to 6.5 from a high of 7.554 three or four weeks ago. Unfortunately, for the PSEI to have a more sustainable upleg, it needs to first establish a base, and establishing a base takes a bit of time. So it needs to move sideways. Let some bargain hunting actions take place, and once we see that particular base, it's only then that the PSEI can perhaps overcome the 7,000 level once again. So assuming that the PSEI is in the process of basing as we speak, it may need at least 3 to 4 weeks time of moving sideways.
Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Spirit Airlines, which filed for bankruptcy protection after years of mounting losses. The budget carrier shares, though, are up 3.7% in pre-market trading. Also in focus, shares of NVIDIA amid reports its new Blackwell AI chip is having overheating issues. NVIDIA shares tumbled nearly 3% before the bell. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of Tesla following reports that the incoming Trump administration will establish a federal framework for fully self-driving vehicles. Shares of the EV maker popped 8% in the pre-market. We're also keeping an eye on Melrose Industries after the aerospace manufacturing company reported a 7% increase in revenue. Melrose shares jumped 8% on the news.
The Philippine Central Bank on Monday announced the launch of a new interest rate swap market. The Bankers Association of the Philippines launched the Enhanced Peso Interest Rate Swap Market following a recognition of the BAP's Philippine Overnight Reference Rate, on which the swaps will be anchored at the short end. The BSP said this marks a crucial step toward boosting trading and liquidity in the domestic bond market. It adds a deeper capital market will enhance savings and investment in the Philippines. 16 banks have committed to be market makers for the overnight reference rate-based IRS, according to the BSP. They will ensure there will be prices for swaps of various maturities from 1 month to 10 year, providing a new way to hedge or take positions. The ORR, in turn, is based on the variable overnight reverse repurchase rate.
The Philippines pushing for scaled-up climate finance flows at the United Nations Climate Change Conference. The finance department is leading negotiations on an annual climate finance target of $1.3 trillion U.S. dollars for developing nations. Finance Undersecretary Maria Lualhati Dorotan Chuseco notes that the country is pushing for sustained and increased financing on behalf of all countries who constantly face catastrophic typhoons. This comes as the UN Secretary General urges Group of 20 members to leverage their economic clout and diplomatic leverage in tackling global problems such as climate change. This as they gather for the G20 summit in Brazil. The major economies are the largest contributors to multilateral development banks, helping to steer climate finance. But they're also responsible for more than three quarters of greenhouse emissions worldwide.
The climate crisis has burned through another record, with 2024 likely to be the hottest year in history. We see the impacts everywhere, and look no further than the drought in the Amazon and horrible floods in southern Brazil.
Please welcome the President of the United States.
Have a man.